that our God would count you worthy of his calling and fulfill all the good pleasures of his goodness and the work of faith with power, that the name of our Lord Jesus Christ may be glorified in you and you in him, according to the grace of God and the Lord Jesus Christ. Look to see all of God's goodness being worked out in us. Now imagine what our lives would be like if we would be able to surrender and see everything that God wants to work in us and then through us. Because first he has to work in us and then work through us. But how beautiful would your life be? How amazing would your household be? If you're married, your marriages, if you have children, your family, you know, to have that alignment with God, that we don't have to question whether we turn to the right or to the left because we're so close to him that we know exactly what he's telling us. You know, and the presence of having him with us all the time. I think sometimes we forget that he's truly with us all the time. But we put him aside, but he's there. He's there longing to speak to us, longing, you know, to share his heart with us, longing to hear from us. You know, we have a God. There's so many verses in the Bible that talk about God inclining his ear to hear what we have to say. You know, what a beautiful picture to know that God today, tonight, you know, it's just like, my children are talking to me. My children are praying for each other. You know, that's family. That's what it's all about. You know, so again, when you leave this place, you know that the Spirit of God is with you. The Holy Spirit indwells us. You know, he's with us, and there's nothing that we cannot come before him and to talk to him about. He beckons us to come into his kingdom, you know, to come into his throne, you know, to sit at his feet. You know, if that doesn't encourage you and that doesn't lift your spirits up to know that God is with you, always, literally always. I don't know what else. And I would ask for you to do something too.
This is a great hand. I love it. If you guys would extend your hands out, so we can pray for him too. Dear God, we thank you so much for what you've done here this week. We thank you so much for who you are, and your character and your unconditional love and your peace. And God, we thank you for your majesty and how powerful you are in your creation and how, man, just how amazing you are and how you never leave us and you never forsake us, Lord, and how you want to move mountains for us and all we need to have is a mustard seed of faith. And God, we pray for our head, Lord. We pray for our senior pastor, God. We pray that your spirit will pour upon him. Lord, we pray double portions of your spirit that you just be like, God, we pray for wisdom. We pray for discernment, Lord. We pray for vision. God, we pray for open doors. We pray that your favor would go before him, Lord. We pray that your hand would be upon him, Lord. We pray that you would keep him, Lord, that you would empower him, that you would give him boldness, God, to go through the wall that you, the doors that you asked him to go through, Lord. We pray that you would create the way, that you would, your word says that you're left unto our feet, God, that he would literally see that light onto his feet as he's making decisions and walking through us, Lord, that his heart and your heart would be entwined, that when he speaks from this platform, it wouldn't be him speaking, but it would be your word speaking from him, Lord, God, that you would empower him again, Lord, God, that, God, he would be like Moses, when Moses left the presence, that the Shekinah glory was upon him, God, that he would have that upon him, Lord, that when people would see him, they wouldn't see anything but you, Lord, when he would pray for somebody, it wouldn't be him praying, but it would be your spirit through him praying. Lord, when he would give a word of knowledge, a word of encouragement, a word of wisdom, God, that it wouldn't be him saying it, but it would be you saying it, Lord. God, just fill him. Fill it to overflow, Lord. God, that his word would just ooze who you are, God. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
That you would always be the most important person in this place, Lord. That you